सत्यम वदा धर्मचरा सत्यमेव जयते। गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, सुप्रभात। आई एम विपुल कुमार, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टुडे न्यूज डेस्क ऑन इनकम टैक्स, जीएसटी एंड कॉर्पोरेट लॉस। लेट्स कवर न्यूज ऑन इनकम टैक्स। मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस इशू प्रेस रिलीज डेटेड 18th जुलाई 2020। In this press release, new form 26AS is a faceless hand holding of taxpayer to e-file ITR correctly. The CBDT has said that the new form 26AS is the faceless hand holding of the taxpayer to e-file their income tax returns quickly and correctly. Information received by the Income Tax Department from the Statement of Financial Transaction will be shown under Part E of Form 26AS. It will facilitate voluntary compliance, tax accountability, and ease of e-filing of ITR. Chandigarh Tribunal in a case, no rectification if disputed issue having two possible opinions settled through Finance Act Amendment. In this case, it was a highly debatable issue whether in pre-amendment provision of Section 54F, that is, in assessment year 2011-12 and earlier, word assessee meant an individual only, or it also included an HUF who can claim deduction under Section 54B. Powers under Section 154 could not be exercised to disallow claim of HUF when issue was already examined by assessing official in a scrutiny assessment proceedings. Delhi Tribunal, in a case, ITAT upholds validity of reassessment as assessee was one of beneficiary of bogus share transaction. In this case, where assessee declare long-term capital gain arising from sale of shares are exempt under Section 1038 in view of fact that there were certain entry operators providing accommodation interest in respect of bogus share transaction and assessee was one of beneficiaries. Assessing officer was justified in reopening assessment. Second decision taken in this case, where assessing officer made addition to assessee's income under Section 68 in respect of capital gain earned from sale of shares by taking said transaction as bogus, in view of fact that shares were purchased and sold through security broker by online portal, and moreover security transaction tax was also paid, impact addition was to be deleted. Ministry of Finance issued press release 17th July 2020. In this press release, CBDT issued refund worth 71,229 crore to help taxpayer with liquidity in COVID-19 pandemic. The CBDT has issued refund worth 71,229 crore in more than 21.24 lakhs cases up to 11th July 2020 to help taxpayers with liquidity in COVID-19 pandemic days. It is further emphasized that all the refund related cleaning up the tax demands are being taken upon priority and is likely to be completed by 31st August 2020. Delhi Tribunal Committee established under Bar Council to safeguard the interest of the advocates eligible for exemption under Section 12A and 80G. In this case, Delhi Tribunal held Advocate Welfare Fund Trustee Committee established under Bar Council of Delhi being engaged in safeguarding right, privilege and interest of advocates. Its dominant purpose is the advancement of general public utility within meaning of Section 2 Clause 15. Bombay High Court, in a case, obsolete stocks of laptop and motherboard which couldn't be sold is allowable as expenditure. In this case, obsolete stock which was not disposed of or sold was allowable as an expenditure under Section 37, Subsection 1. Ministry of Finance issued press release dated 18th July 2020. In this press release, CBDT starts 11 days e-campaign to promote voluntary compliance of ITR filing for assessment year 1920. Now it is 9 days. The CBDT has started 11 days e-campaign on voluntary compliance of the income tax for the convenience of taxpayer flow. 20th July 2020, a SMS or an email will be sent to taxpayer to verify their financial transaction related information received by income tax department. The objective of e-campaign to promote voluntary compliance of filing of belated or revised ITR so that taxpayer don't get into notice and scrutiny process. Let's cover news on another news on income tax. Karnataka High Court: ITAT wasn't justified in allocating research and development expenses to another unit if no product were manufactured by such unit. In this case, where no product was manufactured by another unit of SSC company engaged in the business of manufacture and export of pharmaceuticals, tribunal was unjustified in allocating research and development expenditure to said unit of the SSC when no such product were manufactured in said unit of SSC during relevant year. Second decision held in this case, where SSC company engaged in business of manufacture and export of pharmaceuticals incurred an amount towards research and development in view of section 35 subsection 1, same was to be excluded from the total capital expenditure while allowing expenditure on research and development units. Let's cover news on GST. Supreme Court decision: Messer Ultratech Cement Limited versus a state of Rajasthan and other. This decision dated 17th July 2020. In this case, Supreme Court held excessive subsidy given under RIAPS scheme could be refunded. 12% interest should be paid instead of 18%. Supreme Court upheld revision order passed by the department demanding refund of excess subsidy of 25% paid under the Rajasthan Investment Policy Scheme RIAPS along with interest at rate of 18%. The court held that the SSC is entitled to benefit of only to the extent of 50% of VAT deposited and no to the extent of 75%. It is further held that the interest shall be applicable at the rate of 12% instead of 18%. There is a news on GST portal. Anti-measure for revocation application of cancel registration rejected before 12th June 2020 via appeal. Anti-measure has been proposed for those taxpayer whose application for revocation of cancellation of registration has been rejected by the tax authority before 12th June 2020, the taxpayer can request the appellate authority or the higher authority to pass offline order on it for restoration of the application. Based on such order, jurisdictional authority can restore the application for revocation or cancellation. In this news, in case your application for revocation or cancellation of registration was rejected by the tax authority before 12th June 2020 and you wish to avail benefit of research and development order dated 25th June 2020 as an interim measure, you can request the appellate authority or the higher authority to pass a simple offline order on it to restoration of the application. And based on the such order, your jurisdictional authority can restore the application for revocation or cancellation. You need to apply post-login registration, restore registration, restore revocation. You have to enter ARN of the order and would require to upload a scanned copy of the order passed after clicking appeal in favor. And third, GSTN is working on to remove present restriction on reapplication of the revocation or cancellation application after that filing of revocation of petition would become one step process. It is expected to be available shortly. The above suggested solution is an interim measure provided to taxpayers. Another Chennai says foreclosure charges are damaged and not consideration, no service charge. In this case, foreclosure charges collected by banks and non-banking financial companies on premature termination of loans are not leviable to service tax. Let's cover news on insurance law. IRDA circular dated 16 July 2020. IRDA issues guideline on settlement of claim on treatment of a temporary hospital as permitted by government. IRDA has issued the guidelines on settlement of the claim on the treatment at makeshift or temporary hospital as permitted by government. Insurers are advised to expedite settlement of all such claims in accordance to the applicable regulatory framework. Let's cover news from SEBI. SEBI circular dated 17 July 2020, SEBI comes up with the mechanism of providing exit option to dissenting unit holders of RITS and INVITS. The SEBI has issued manner of mechanism of providing exit option to dissenting unit holders of RITS and INVITS, whereby it has been specified that an acquirer providing exit option to dissenting unit holders in terms of the circular shall appoint one or more merchant banker registered with the board as lead manager for the exit option or offer, who shall ensure compliance with the provision of the SEBI RIT and INVITS regulations. Let's cover news from Insolvency Bankruptcy Code, National Company Law, Appellate Tribunal. Inter-se agreement between financial creditor will not override Section 7. Inter-se agreement between bank and financial creditor will not be a bar to filing Section 7 application. In another case, NCLAT Section 61, Subsection 2 of Insolvency Bankruptcy Code overrides Section 5 of the Limitation Act. In view of the overriding effect of the provision of Section 238 of the IBC, Section 61, Subsection 2 of Section of IBC will override Section 5 of the Limitation Act. In another case, NCLAT, mere intention of the proceeding before MSME authorities wouldn't show pre-existing disputes so as to bar a plea under Section 9. Merely because operational creditor had initiated proceeding before micro, small and medium enterprise authority would not show that there was pre-existing disputes so as to be bar a petition under Section 9. In another case, NCLAT, dishonoring of chain issued at the time of the settlement amount to default on part of corporate debtor, where corporate debtor had clearly acknowledged its liability by entering into settlement agreement with operational creditor, dishonoring of check issued at time of settlement amount to default on part of corporate debtor, and therefore application under Section 9 filed by operational creditor had rightly been admitted. NCL Mumbai resolution application directed to make payment within a bid to pay upfront consideration to financial creditors. Consideration to financial creditor within 30 business days, but payment was not made. Application of monitoring agency to NCLT. For implementation of resolution plan was justified and resolution applicant was to be directed to make payment within a week. Now, another case, NCLT Guwahati, CIRP plea under Section 7 admitted as responded company failed to repay loan taken from bank even after one-time settlement. In view of inability of responded company to repay loan taken from applicant, bank even as per terms of one time settlement arrived at between parties in SAS application filed under section 7 was to be admitted. Let's cover news from the Consumer Protection Act. Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution Department of Consumer Affairs notification dated 15 July 2020. Government notified Consumer Protection Consumer Dispute Register Commission Rule 2020. In this notification, the government notified rule on Consumer Protection Register Commission Rules 2020, wherein various provisions related to working days and office of the National Commission. Seal and enable sitting of the National Commission, manner of the authentication, fees for making complaint, and so on have been discussed in details in this school. Thank you so much for watching this news channel on income tax, GST, and corporate law. We are trying to cover all laws, insurance law, FEMA, international taxation, consumer protection, Act, income tax, and GST is the main law and the company law. So we are covering all notifications, circulars, and case law of all High Court, NCLT, SAT, Tribunal, and trying to update it on daily basis. Please share this news channel among professional colleagues or students who are interested in updating knowledge, enhancing knowledge. So then they are. Ultimately, our object is the benefit of all person, and updation will be provided on regular basis so that they are updated on daily basis. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching this video.